शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे परम्परां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तहुं हदेव आत्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मोक्षुर्वै शरणं। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। प्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्गत्यं अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परमः तदेव अनुक्तमतिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानुमोदयम्।
Praveen ji, screen is not visible.
It should be visible now. Is it visible now?
No.
Anything's happening? Okay. Yeah, because I logged off then to get the mic working. Okay.
Yeah, now, no, it's visible. Yes, yes.
So, Shadvidha Pramaha, Shadvidaha Pramaha. We'll start with that and hope that the internet continues. Okay. So, Idanim, Shadvidha Pramaha Nirdishyante. There are six types of Prama. Prama is valid knowledge which cannot be sublated by other knowledge. So, that is the Shadvidha Prama here. And we have seen the six Pramanas, which are means to lead to valid prama. So those are in keeping with each and every pramana, there is a unit of knowledge, which is prama. So pratyaksha prama, anumiti prama, upamiti prama, shabdi prama, arthapatti prama, abhava prama cheti. Each in keeping with pratyaksha pramanam, anumana pramanam, upamana pramanam, shabda pramanam, arthapatti pramanam and abhava pramanam. For abhava, there will be, we'll see what is the pramana for abhava. It was mentioned, but then we'll see more. Purvoktani pratyakshadi pramanani kramena etasam shandam pramana karanani bhunti. So each of the earlier pramanas that we saw respectively are the karanas. So they are karanas, tritiyarthe. So karaka, tritiya karaka. In the vibhakti, you have the karane tritiya. So that is the means to each of the prama. And earlier I mentioned jnanam also. When you say jnanam, jnanam is lyut pratyanta. Therefore, what kind of vyutpatti should be inquired into whenever jnanam is used? And this is done in satyam jnanam anantam brahma, satyam jnanam anantam brahma, lakshana vakya in Chaitri Upanishad. Under that mantra, in the bhashya, when Bhagavan Bhashyakara analyzes jnanam, he mentions some karakas, and when he finishes the satchit and ananda, after that he comes back, takes the purva paksha on jnana, where there is an objection about jnana having a jnadhatu with the anapratya. Ana is by your anakau sutra, it is a replacement for lyut. And lyut is usually in bhave, karane and adhikarane arthe. So vyutpatti can be bhave, which is a shuddha dhatu artha, where Bhagavan Bhashyakara takes that pick and says it is bhava sadhana. Bhava sadhana means bhave vyutpatti. Or it can be karane vyutpatti, adhikarana vyutpatti generally, or broadly it can be akartari chakarake sanyayam. It can be in any of the karakas except for kartru karaka. Similarly, when you see karana, so jnana and karana, it is also lyud pratyanta. Here karana is tritiya. Tritiya arthe derivation, and karana, it is what is it tritiya there? Karana meaning it's a means to something. So jnana karane arthe is means to something, whereby jnana itself can be karana, can be pramana, and it can also be bhavi vitpatti, where it means just knowledge, which is prama. So jnana can mean pramana as well as prama. So we have to be a little cautious on what the meaning of jnana is in context. So that's an aside. It just struck me when I was explaining karana. So pramanam, shannam pramanam karanani bhavanti. Etasam. For each of these pramas, there is a pramana, individual pramana. There can be only one pramana or one prama. Everything else can be possible by dependency, but there will be only one prama. Just like one pramana for one prama. For example, eyes can see, ears can hear. You cannot swap them. You cannot say that I can see through my eyes, but then why not through my ears? Similarly, shabda pramana alone can lead to atma jnana. There cannot be any other pramana. So shabda pramana has that kind of an importance. Vedanta is the only pramana for, Shruti Vakya is the only pramana for jnanutpatti, atma jnanutpatti. Okay, so that is the karana, pramana. So pramanas are karana, that is the definition. Karana lakshanam kim? What is the definition for karana? Tatra pratyaksha pramayaha karanam pratyaksha pramanam ityuchyate. We started by definition of pramana as prama karanam pramanam. Shashti tatpurusha pratyaksha pramayaha karanam pratyaksha pramanam. So shashti tatpurusha in what? Prama karanam pramanam. Pramayaha karanam pramanam. Then for each and every prama, there is a particular pramana. Therefore, pratyaksha prama, what is the karana? It is pratyaksha pramana. Tatra pratyaksha pramayaha karanam pratyaksha pramanam ityuchyate. Now, what is karanam? When we use the definition, in short, it was a madhyama. Madhyama pada lopi samasa, if you make, you will get prama karanam pramanam. That's the broad definition anyway, which is given in Vedanta Paribhasha also. So prama karanam pramanam, there prama is inquired into, pramanam is inquired into. Now in the definition you have karanam. So karanam has to be understood. What is karanam? Asadharana karanam eva karanam. There are many karanas, causes to any effect. There can be many. Generally, there are many. We may not know that there are other karanas as well. Ishvara, Ishvara, Ichha, Kala, all these are necessary. Akasha is also, Akasha is needed as Avakasha Pradhatu. So there are unknown or unthought of karanas when we inquire into a karana for any karya. But whatever is asadharana, there are many sadharana karanas that lead to many karyas, but whatever is asadharana to the karya that is being inquired into, that karana is karana. So here there is a tippana, asadharana karanam eva karanam, that is the karana lakshana. So kevala asadharana karanam karanam ityukte, when you say only asadharana karanam is karana, then what does it mean? Yatra asadharana karana dvayam praptam tatra idam eva karanam iti vinigamaka bhavat ekasya dvara rupa karanattvam anyasya vyaparavat asadharana karanattva rupa karanattvam cha abhyupeyam. Now this is a little technical. I'll not go into details, because there is something called as vyaparavat matu pratyantha. Nayayikas consider the karana. When they look into karana, they say that can be karana which has a vyapara. That which itself is dwaraka, which helps the vyapara, that cannot be karana. So vyaparavat, if it is pullinga, we'll understand better as vyaparavan, vyapara yuktam. So whatever is vyaparavat, meaning that which has vyapara, that is asadharana karana. So thereby, being asadharana karana, it will become karana. When you have multiple karanas. So here, yatra asadharana karana dvayam. If you have asadharana karana also, more than one, praptam. Tatra idam eva karanam iti vinigamaka bhava. Since you cannot make out a difference as to which is the karana, this idam ittham, you know, only this is karana, because kevala asadharana karanam is karanam. If you cannot make out the difference as to which is the karana, because both are asadharana, if one is missing, then you don't get that karya. And for that particular karya, not for others, for that particular karya, both of the asadharana karanas are necessary. So they both lead to the karya. In that case, if you cannot make out the difference, since it cannot be made out as to which is the real karana in this, then what should be considered as karana is said here, dvara rupa karanattvam anyasya vyaparavat asadharana karanattva rupa karanattvam cha abhyupeyam. So that which is vyaparavat should be considered as karana, while the other can be considered as dvara rupa karana. Asadharana karana, all right, but still dvara rupa, it is a dvara to attain the karya. It is a means to attain the karya, but it is that which may serve as a vyapara to the other. Actually, a dvara to the other, which has vyapara. Yattu dvara rupa karanam puraskritya karyam janayati. So here it is elaborated. Yattu dvara rupa karanam puraskritya karyam janayati. So that asadharana karana which leads to karya, using another asadharana karana which becomes a dvara for it, for the karya to be effected, tadeva asadharana karana rupam karanam bhavati. So that will be called as karana. The other is not called as karana. Tadyatha. So here the example is given to drive home the point, because these are all, you know, definitions which are very dry. You don't understand unless there is an example. So we don't need to go into more details if you don't understand it, which is all right. So yattu dvara rupa karanam puraskritya karyam janayati tadeva asadharana karana rupam karanam bhavati. In the example, what is the dvara rupa karana and what is the that which is vyaparavat? Tadyatha kapala dvayam. So the two parts of the pot, you know, there are some big pots where two parts are created and they are clubbed together, they are joined together with some solution. So kapala dvayam, tadyatha kapala dvayam sanyoga dvara ghadasya utpadakatvat ghadam prati vyaparavat asadharana karana rupam karanam. So kapala dvaya is vyaparavat. How so? Without the kapala, asadharana karana, first of all, it is asadharana karana. Kapala dvayam, the two parts of the pot which are put together are asadharana karana, because without the kapala you cannot get the ghata. And they sanyoga dvara, so what is the means by which they come together and result in a karya? Sanyoga dvara, there is a sanyoga of the kapala dvaya. So thereby sanyoga dvara ghatasya utpadakatvat ghatam prati vyaparavat asadharana karana rupam karanam. It has vyapara, and thereby, since they come together, that through that vyapara, they become the asadharana karana. They are the kapala dvayam. It's a single single duet there. Yattu vyapara shunyam sat dvara karanam anapeksha sakshadeva karyam janayati tat kevala karanam natu karanam. So that which does not have vyapara, which is not vyapara, what means which does not have vyapara, that is kevala karana, it is not karana, it is vyapara shunya, but it is dvara karanam anapeksha sakshadeva karyam janayati. It is vyapara shunyam, it results in the karya, but not having a vyapara, sakshad janayati karyam, directly results in an effect, but without having any dvara karanam anapeksha, it does not have anything in between them, directly results in a karya. That is called as kevala karana, it is not karana. Yatha kapala dvaya sanyoga. So sanyoga is useful for the kapala dvaya to result in the karya. So sanyoga is needed, kapala dvaya is also needed. So both are asadharana karana. You cannot have just kapala dvaya, not have association of them. You will not get a karya ghata. Now if you have sanyoga, sanyoga means what? You have means to bring something together. You know, if you give some two things, you can join them together. Right? Just for argument's sake. But then you don't have the kapala dvaya. Then what can be joined together? You don't have anything to join together. If kapala dvaya is replaced by some other dvaya, you can still have sanyoga, but that will not result in a ghata. Therefore, kapala dvaya is needed. Sanyoga is also needed. Both are asadharana karana for the ghata. But sanyoga results in the ghata directly. It does not use any other vyapara. Whereas kapala dvaya uses sanyoga. So yatha kapala dvaya sanyoga sakshadeva ghatot padakatvat kevala karanam natu karanam. So in the example of ghatotpatti, kapala dvaya is karana, sanyoga is karana, kevala karana. Both are asadharana karana, but kapala dvaya alone is karana. Further, vyaparavad asadharana karanam karanamityasya lakshanasya pratyakshanumana shabdakhya pramaneshu sambhaveyapi upamanartha patyonupalabhyakhya pramaneshu asambhavad avyaptihi. Now there, avyapti and the lakshana is inquired into. So, vyaparavad asadharana karanam karanam, when you define it in this manner, ityasya lakshanasya pratyaksha anumana shabdakhya pramaneshu sambhaveyapi upamanarthapati. So, they divided because pratyaksha anumana shabda, basically these feed into upamana, arthapati and anupalabdhi. Therefore, in one, the definition is fitting. Another, it is not fitting. Therefore, there is another set. It is not fitting. Therefore, there is avyapti. It does not cover all the pramanas. Because karanam, we have said, prama karanam, pramanam. Then, the definition of karanam should fit the pramana. Otherwise, and all pramanas. So, here it is fitting the first three, these pratyaksha anumana shabda. Whether first or not, these three, where the other three it is not fitting in. Therefore, there is avyapti in the lakshana. It falls short. Avyapti means basically it falls short. It does not cover all the pramanas. Karana lakshana does not cover all the pramanas. Upamiti adinam. Upamityadinam. Janane vinayeva vyaparam. Upamanadinam. Karanatva sambhavat. Purvokta karana lakshanasya tatra avyapti syat. So, vina eva vyaparam upamiti. Upamiti does not have any vyapara. So, vina eva vyaparam upamanadinam karanatva sambhava. So, upamiti as a karya, upamana is pramana. Because upamiti is a prama and prama karanam is pramanam. So, what is the pramana? What is the karana for upamiti? Upamana. So that upamanadinam vyaparam vinayev in janana of upamiti ityadi. So this upamana, arthapatti and anupalabdi, these three. For these three are pramanas for upamiti, arthapatti prama and anupalabdi prama, meaning abhava prama. Abhava prama, they do not have any vyaparas. These pramanas do not have a vyapara. Then how can they be called as karana? They are karana. So vyaparam vinayeva. Upamanadinam karanatva sambhava. It is possible for them to be karana, asadharana karana, but they don't have vyapara. Then how can you call it as karana? Purvokta karana lakshanasya tatra avyapti syat. Ataha vyapara bhinnam asadharana karanam karanam ityasya lakshanasya nirdushtatva tadeva sarva pramananugata karana lakshanam. So he's refining that. Swamiji is refining that in the Tippana. He says that instead of saying asadharana karanam karanam, what should be said is that vyapara bhinnam asadharana karanam karanam. So that will take away this avyapti. Anyway, so we'll not spend more time on that. That is, in fact, can be more confusing. So let it be. Especially if you have not studied Tarka Shastra or without the Tarka Shastra basis, Vedanta Paribhasha won't be clear. And if Vedanta Paribhasha is not clear, then these definitions, with the Tarkika's Navya Nayayika's language, it gets difficult, and it is going to get difficult in this para at least, in the Mula. So I'll try to explain anyway. Okay, so that is Asadharana Karanam. Karanam is the Karana Lakshana, but now we have seen Vyapara Bhinna Asadharana Karanam. Karanam is a definition which is going to take away the avyapti also of asadharana karanam eva karanam. That lakshana has a avyapti dosha which can be taken away. That much is sufficient by saying that vyapara bhinnam asadharana karanam karanam. Yat sakala karyanam tulyataya karanam bhavati tat sadharana karanam. Whereas what is common cause to all karyas, any karya, it need not be ghata, it can be pata also. Ghata needs mruditjadi or kapala dvaya, whereas pata needs tantu. So tantu is asadharana karana for pata, whereas kapala dvaya is asadharana karana for karana, basically asadharana karana and karana thereby for ghata. Now when you compare ghata and pata, what is the asadharana karana? There is nothing which is common, otherwise it won't be asadharana. It has to be asadharana specific, which is uncommon. There is still something common between causes of ghata and pata and all other karyas for the entire prapancha. If you consider anything that goes on, you need to create any karya, something common is needed. That sadharana karana is tulya across all karyas. So yat sakala karyanam tulyataya karanam bhavati tat sadharana karanam. For example, kala. Simple example is kala, which is dismissed. We don't even consider. Every karya takes place in a particular unit of time. That is why time changing, the karya being same, you still have some bhinnatva, some difference between the two, because there is something different. Kala is different. Now, this is a little tricky. This is Navya-Nyaya language. Therefore, it is difficult. The words are technical. I'll try to translate as much as I can. So, karyatvavachinna nishtha karyata nirupita karanata shali yat tat sadharana karanam. So, what is sadharana karanam? We have seen that it is sakala karanam tulyataya karanam. So that is sufficient. If you understand this is sufficient, but this is technically defined now. What exactly is the lakshana? If you look at the lakshana, how do you define it? This is an explanation. But what is the definition? Definition is karyatva chinna nishtha karyata nirupita karanata shali yat tat sadharana karanam. So what is common karana, cause? It is karanata shali. So long compound and more technical words. So we'll go from the reverse order. samasa should be analyzed from the last word, from right to left. So shali, karanata shali, neuter, therefore it is shali here. What is this karanata shali? Karanata yuktam, that's what it means. Karanata yuktam, what is karanata yuktam? That karana should have karanata. Karanata or karanatva, same words. Tasya bhava tvatanau. So karana, karana bhava, karanatva, the status of karana. So karanata is in karana. So yat karanata shali, meaning karanata yuktam, that is sadharana karana. What kind of karanata shali now? That karanata shali which is nirupita, which is karyata nirupita, meaning which is ascertained, known through the karyata. Because karana, when you look at karana, this karana has karanatvam, karanata. What kind of karanata does it have? So it has karanata towards a particular karya. Towards a particular karyata, this is karanata. Therefore, karyata nirupita karanata shali. That karanata shali is, it is known through its karyata. It is connected to a particular karyata. That's why particular of any karyata, here it is sadharana karana, but still it is known, you know the karana through the karya. So therefore, it is karyata nirupita karanata shali. Now, where is this karyata? Karyata also should be there in something. Just like karanata shali, karanata yukta karana. Karanata is in karana. In sadharana karana, there is karanata. And that karanata is connected to some karyata, which is known through some karyata. That karyata, where does it stay? That karyata is nishtha. Is in what? It is present in karyatva avachinna. Something which is karyata avachinna, which meaning karyatva vishishta. Avachinna is vishishta. So karyatva avachinna nishtha karyata nirupita karanata shali. Sadharana karana is that which is there. Sadharana karana is that which is, which has karanata, which is ascertained by a karyata, which karyata, that karyata which is nishtha, present in karyatva avachinna. Karyatva avachinna what? Karyatva avachinna karyeshu nishtha. That which is there in all products which have karyatva. So in all those which have karyatva, what will have karyatva? Only karya will have karyatva. Therefore, karyeshu nishtha. That karyata which is there in all karyas which have karyatva. And all karyas means any karya has karyatva. Therefore, karyatva avachinna karyeshu. That is sakaleshu. Sakala karyeshu. So here, yet sakala karyanam tulyataya karanam. We can understand this karyatva avachinna is talking about sakala karya. So sakala karyeshu nishtha karyata. That karyata which is there in all karyas, because every karya will have karyatva. Therefore, karyatva avachinna means sakala karya. So sakala karyeshu nishtha ya nishtha ya karyata taya nirupita karanata taya nirupitam karinata shali yat tat sadharana karanam. So that is the explanation, that is the definition for the explanation given earlier of sadharana karana. Then what is asadharana karana? For, to land on that, the, first of all, example. So dharma dharmadikam sakala karyanam karanatva sadharana karanam. So example for sadharana karanam is dharma adharma punya papa. So dharma adharma adi. So adi panna, Ishwar Ichha is considered there, but Kala, we can take Kala. Sakala Karyanam Karanatvat Sadharana Karanam. So Dharma, Adharma, these are all needed. Otherwise, you will not have this prapancha itself. And then thereby no activity is going to be possible, no circumstances are created if there is no dharma adharma backing. Each jiva has a dharma adharma backing, which is sought after to fructify into something. There is some bhoga which is due to each and every jiva, therefore the jagat creation, and therefore each and every karya which is called as jagat. We call jagat as that which is karya. And this karya, you see, within the jagat also there are more karyas, more and more karyas. Every now and then something is being produced. All that is produced for the bhoga of the jiva. So it is all coming together. It is put together for the sake of the bhoga of the jiva. But then dharma adharma is common for all of this. Each and every karya will have some dharma adharma backing. So these are sakala. Sadharana karana. Sakala karyana karana bhavam anasadhya. Katipaya karyanam eva vishishya karana bhavam yad bhajate tad sadharana karana. So that which is yukta, bhajate yukta, or which partakes of karana bhavam, means karanattam or karanata, that which has karanata, but it is vishesha. Sakala karyanam, sakala karyanam karana bhavam anasadhya. That which is not there in all karyas, that which does not lead to all karyas, it katipaya karyanam eva vishishya karana bhavam yad bhajati. That which is karana, that which has karana bhava, meaning that which has karanattam or karanata, for only some particular katipaya karyana eva vishishya karana, that which has karanatta or karanattam, meaning karana bhavam, for only katipaya karya, not sakala karya, that is asadharana karana, tad asadharana karanam. This is the explanation. What is the definition, lakshana? So Nayayika's definition or Vedanti's definition using the Tarkika's language, Navyan Nyaya language, karyatvatirikta dharmavachinna nishtha karyata nirupita karanata shaliyat tad asadharana karanam. So in contrast to the sadharana karanam, which has karyatva avachinna nishtha karyata, not which has, but which is karyatva avachinna nishtha karyata nirupita karanata shali, this is karyatvatirikta dharma, karyatvatirikta dharma avachinna nishtha karyata nirupita karanata shali. So if you compare karanata shali, here also you have karanata shali. So asadharana karanam is also karanata shali, meaning it is karanata yuktam. It has karanata, but what kind of karanata? That karanata which is nirupita by karyata, just like earlier. Every karanata is nirupita by karyata. So this asadharana karana has karanata which is nirupita by karyata, but that karyata, where is it nishtha? That karyata is nishtha in karyatvatirikta dharma avachinna. It is nishtha in karyatvatirikta dharma avachinna. So we come to avachinna. What is karyatvatirikta dharma? Here it was karyatva avachinna. Karyatva avachinna are all karyas, sakala karya. Here karyatva atirikta dharma. So sakala karyas earlier had karyata, karyatva. Karyatva was a dharma. Here karyatva atirikta dharma. Other than karyatva, we don't need karyatva dharma. We need something other than karyatva dharma. So the example can be, here the danda with ghatotpatti is taken as an example. So we'll take ghatatva. Ghatatva is also a dharma. Just like karyatva is a dharma, ghatatva is a dharma. So karyatva atirikta dharma is ghatatva. Is ghatatva karyatva? No. Ghatatva is different from karyatva. Therefore, karyatva atirikta dharma is ghatatva. That ghatatva avachinna. So just as an example, ghatatva. Don't take only ghatatva. Any example would do which is not karyatva. Any dharma example. So So karyatvadirikta dharmavachinna. What will be the ghatatvavachinna? Here karyatvavachinna will be sakala karya. All karyas are karyatvavachinna. So what will be ghatatvavachinna? It will be all ghatas. So ghatatvavachinna will be all ghatas. Patatvavachinna will be all patas. But they are all karyatva atirikta dharma. So karyatva atirikta dharmavachinna. Again, karyeshu, which are those? Ghatatvachinna karyeshu ghateshu. Nishtha karyata nirupita karanata shaniyat. Tat asadharana karanam. So if you take ghatatva, then ghatatvachinna ghateshu, nishtha. In those ghatas, which have ghatatva, which is different from karyatva, in those, that karyata which is there, which ascertains karanata, or karanata which is ascertained by, to be literal, karanata which is ascertained by karyata, which is nishtha in ghatas, which have ghatatva, which is bhinna from karyatva, atirikta from karyatva. So only in those ghatas it is there. That ghatatva which is there, which is ascertained by some karanata, that karanata yuktayat, that is asadharana karanam. So example is dandohi na sakala karyanam karanam bhavati. Danda is not a karana for everything. For every karya, you cannot make every karya through danda. So danda is not needed. For other karyas, kintu ghatadi rupa karya visheshanam eva karanam bhavati. So danda is needed only for ghatadi rupa karya visheshanam, for the specific karyas, which are ghata ityadi, where danda is needed as karana. Therefore, tasma dando ghatadi nam asadharana karanam iti karanam iti cha uchyate. So danda becomes the karana by being the asadharana karana for ghata. Evamiyo pratyaksha pramayaha. So now you have to, now you're taking this example and the definitions and the explanations given for sadharana and asadharana karana in the inquiry of karana lakshana. What has been done is now you extend it to the pramana and prama in the context. Evam eva pratyaksha pramayaha ishraha tadikchadayascha sadharana karanani. So what are the sadharana karana in the pratyaksha prama ityadi? When pratyaksha prama, what is pratyaksha prama? It is resultant of pratyaksha pramana. So pratyaksha pramana is karana, pratyaksha prama is karya. So pratyaksha pramana is a specific asadharana karana for pratyaksha prama. What is the sadharana karana for pratyaksha prama? Evameva pratyaksha pramayaha ishraha tadikchadayascha sadharana karanani. General causes are ishvara and ishvara iccha. Tippanakara elaborates this in the second tippana. Adi shabdena ishraha tadikchadi. So ishvara and ishvara iccha is needed for any karya to fructify. That is why we say tena vina trunamapi na chalati. Even for a grass to move, there is a karana who is Ishvara. Tena Ishvarena vina. Now Ishvara iccha is needed. Otherwise you cannot have anything which is a resultant. Therefore Ishvara, Ishvara iccha is needed. Then Adi Shabdena ought to be included. Adi Shabdena Ishvarasya jnanam. Ishvara should know how to create the prapancha. For my pratyaksha prama to take place, Ishvara should know who has become Jiva, really. Otherwise, pratyaksha prama cannot take place. Ishvara should know how pratyaksha prama should take place. What is pratyaksha pramana? What should be useful in what karya? He should know all that. That is why everything works, you know, what they say, clockwork, with so meticulous. The niyati is so meticulous, we may not know. We may think that it is all chaotic. It is not chaotic. Had it been chaotic, we wouldn't have sunrises and gravity and, you know, tides and stuff like that. each and every at the micro and macro level is in sync with Isharaha, Ishara Ichha, Ishara Jnana, Ishara Prayatnaha, Kala, Dik, Adrishtam, Pragabhava, Pratibandaka Bhavaschaiti, Saptagriyante. So there are seven Sadharana Karanas. So Saptagriyante Adi Shabdena. Isharasya Jnanam, Isharasya Prayatnaha, all these are easy to understand. Kalaha, Dik, Adrishtam, Pragabhava, Pratibandaka Bhavaschaiti, Saptagriyante. Other than what? Ishara and Ishara Ichha. So those two plus these Adi Shabdena Sapta Griyante. There are seven more. Ami Ishwaradayaha Nava Sarvakaryana Sadharana Karanani. So there are nine Sadharana Karanas for all Karyas. Without Ishwara you cannot have Ghata, you cannot have Pata. Without his Ichha also you cannot have. He has to have Jnana and Prayatna. His effort is backing. Without Kartrutva Bhava, you have to understand, just because Prayatna is there does not mean that Kartrutva is there. He has no Kartrutva, but there is Prayatna. Kala is needed, Dik is needed, need to be done in some, Dik includes that, you know, direction. Direction can be only in space. So Kala, Dik, Adrishtam. Adrishtam is Dharma Dharmadikam, is needed. Pragabhava, you cannot make a Ghata without Ghata Pragabhava. Ghata should be absent to create a Ghata. The same Ghata that you are creating, that cannot be present. You cannot claim what is already produced as your creation. So, Pragabhava of that particular Karya is needed. Pratibandaka Bhavascha, and there should be no obstacle. So, this is Nayayika says that if you want to make a Ghata, but then there is a Pratibandaka. You know, so many failures. You know, there are some people who feel that everything that they do, you know, there are obstacles. Something or else goes wrong. Like for example, for our class, I put an effort, but my effort is not sufficient because there is so much of prarabdha. You will also feel that I want to attend the class, but I can't. Something goes wrong. The computer fails, internet fails. And so many things going wrong for us right now. Why? Because pratibandhakas are there. So the karya, whatever we are trying to get to, that does not get done. Because of Pratibandhaka. So Pratibandhaka Abhava is also needed. Obstacles should be absent. The product which is being created should not be already created. And then Adrushta Ityadi are clear. So these are all needed for anything to come to effect. And what is coming to effect here? Here we have the we have the Prama as the Karya here. So, Isharya here. I color-coded it, but it's still not clear. Yasmad Isharadeha Sakala Karyani Prati Karanani Bhavanti. So, for all Karyas, Isharadis are Karanas, Sadharana Karanas. Yasmacha Nakinchidapi Karyam Isharadikam Vina Utpadyate Tasmad Ishwaradaya Sadharana Karanani. Since Ishwara, Ishwara Ichha, Jnana, Prayatna Ityadi, all those are Karanas for all Karyas. But what kind of Karanas? They are Sadharana Karana because without them, Kinchidapi Karyam na Utpadyate. There is not a single karya which will come about without Ishara, Ishara, Ichha, Prayatna, Ityadi, Kala, Dik being there. Therefore, they are karanas for everything. Thereby, they are sadharana karanas. Chakshuradi indriyani pratyaksha pramam prati asadharana karanani. However, what is the asadharana karana for pratyaksha prama ityadi? Chakshuradini indriyani. For pratyaksha prama, chakshu is needed. Tok is needed. All these are indriyas are needed and they are asadharana karana. Towards each and every pratyaksha, they are asadharana karana. Atahatani pratyaksha pramam prati karanani cha bhavanti. And being asadharana karana, as per the definition, asadharana karanam karanam, and tippanakara has added as व्यापार भिन्न असाधारण कारण व्यापार भिन्न असाधारण कारण करणम देयरफॉर दीज बीइंग असाधारण कारण दे आर इज इंद्रियाज आर करणास फॉर प्रत्यक्ष प्रमा एंड देयरफॉर चक्षुरादि इंद्रियाज आर व्हाट बीइंग करणास दे आर प्रमाण प्रमाकरणं प्रमाणं देयरफॉर चक्षुरादि इंद्रियाणि बीइंग असाधारण कारण देविकं करण एंड देयरफॉर दे आर प्रमाण एवञ्च चक्षुरादीनि इंद्रियाणि प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाणानि इति उच्यन्ते सो फर्स्ट व्हाट इज दी असाधारण कारण फॉर प्रत्यक्ष प्रमा व्हाट इज दी साधारण कारण इफ यू इंक्वायर इनटू साधारण कारण इज ईश्वरादि फॉर एवरीथिंग देयरफॉर फॉर प्रत्यक्ष प्रमा आल्सो साधारण कारण दा ईश्वरादि देन व्हाट इज दी असाधारण कारण चक्षुरादि इंद्रियाणि Once you know that asadharana karanas, then they become karanas also. And being karanas, they are pramana also. So pratyaksha pramanas are chakshuradi indriyas. So we have landed on pratyaksha prama karana as pratyaksha pramana. In the 213th avartha, pramat pramana prama prameya chaitanyani. There is a purva paksha to this. So the Purva Pakshi says, Nanu, you have Chaitanya. So you say Pramatra Chaitanya, Pramana Chaitanya, Prama Chaitanya, Prameya Chaitanya. These are the Chaitanyas that you talk about. Chaitanya is one. Nanu, Vedanta Siddhante, here this Chakshu, okay? Chakshuradi Indriyanam, Pratyaksha Pramakarnatum na Yujyate. He says your definition of pramakaranam pramanam. So for pratyaksha pramakaranam, pratyaksha pramanam. He has an objection there. Nanu, Vedanta Siddhanta, in the Vedanta Siddhanta, chakshuradi indriyanam pratyaksha pramakaranattam na vidyate. You cannot say that chakshuradi have pratyaksha prama. These indriyas do not have karanattvam. They are not, meaning what? They are not pratyaksha prama karana. Indriyas are not karana for pratyaksha. Pratyaksha prama. When you say pratyaksha, it's pratyaksha prama. Na yujyate. Why? Because tatahi Vedanta Siddhante chatvaras chaitanya vedah santi. Because you, the Vedantins, talk about four types of Chaitanya Vedas. Therefore, he'll explain. This is the reasoning that Pratyaksha Prama Karanas are not Indriyas. Why? Because you talk about four types of Chaitanyas, which are Pramatru Chaitanyam, Pramana Chaitanyam, Pramiti Chaitanyam, and Pramiti Chaitanyam, Athva Prama Chaitanyam. Pramiti and Prama are same, the same meaning. Pramiti is thin and bhavek thin or prama. So you have prama or pramiti chaitanyam. Then fourth you have prameya chaitanyam. Athwa vishaya chaitanyam. Prameya is nyeya. Nyeya is what? Vishaya. So prameya chaitanyam is also vishaya or called as vishaya chaitanyam. So you have four types of chaitanyas talked about. Pramatri chaitanyam, pramana chaitanyam, and Pramiti Chaitanyam, this is generally known as the Kutastha. It is known as the triad. You know, this is called as the triad which is used. In that we say, you know, the Vishaya, Vishayi, and the Jnana. So Pramana. So there is a Prameya, Pramana, and Pramatra Veda, Triputi. So the word I was trying to recall is Triputi. So Triputi, the triad which is used, so this is an issue if you are switching between Sanskritam and English. One of them comes to mind, both do not come to mind, unfortunately. Okay, so aging memory. Anyway, so Prameya, Pramatru and Pramana, you talked about a lot and then you said that this is how your Vedanta Prakriya is, how you know your Vritti Vyapti and Phala Vyapti takes place. So you talk about Chaitanya, these three types, and then Prameya, Vishaya also is there. Vishaya. Vishaya is there, Pramana is there, Pramatru is there, and Prama is also there. Pramatru, going in the sequence, Pramatru is there, who is the Jnatru. Then there is Pramana, which is the means. Jnana as Pramana. Then there is Pramiti Jnana, yes, also as Jnana, but it is Bhavya Yutpatti. So there is Prama Chaitanya, then Chaitanya, of course. Then Prameya Chaitanya, Vishaya Chaitanya, all these are there. So when you have these four, Vedanta Mate Pramanama Chaitanyam Eva, and you have defined, Vedanta Parivasha says, Siddhante Tu Chaitanyam Eva, Jnanam Chaitanyam Eva. What is Jnanam? It is Chaitanyam Eva. Tachcha Chaitanyam Nityam, and Chaitanya cannot come and go. So where do you have the possibility even to talk about Pramana? Pramana is Karana, Karana for Karya, Prama being Karya. Here your Prama is Chaitanya. Chaitanya cannot be a Karya at all. You are saying Prama is Karya and Prama is Chaitanya in Siddhanta. Chaitanya is Nitya, being Nitya, it cannot be Karya. Then where is the scope to discuss Pramana, which is Karana, which is Karana? There is no scope to discuss this. Therefore, Indriyas cannot be the Pramana or Karana or Karana for Pratyaksha Prama. Because Pratyaksha Prama happens to be Prama. Being Prama, it happens to be Chaitanya. Pramanama Chaitanyam Vedantamate. Chaitanyam tu Nityam. If it is Nitya, na Indriya Janyam. Because not Indriya Janyam. Nityam means not a Karyam. Akaryam. Akaryatvena Karana Pekshayava Nasti. Na Indriya Janyam. But you are specifically not only talking about Karana, you are defining Karana as Karana, Karana as Pramana, and then inquiring into Pratyaksha Prama as to what is the specific Asadharana Karana, which will become Karana, which will become Pramana for that Prama. And that happens to be Indriya. It is not Indriya Janya. Chaitanya is not Indriya Janya. Therefore, Prama is not Indriya Janya. Therefore, Pratyaksha Prama is not Indriya Janya. Then where do you have the connection of Pratyaksha Pramana being Indriyas? Tasma na Indriyam tat Karanam iti chet. If that is the objection, then tanna. That is not an issue. Why? Chaitanyasya pramatva apadika, pramatva apadika vrittirrapi pramaityuchyate. So you have to understand the context, says the Siddhanti. Yes, for us, Prama is Chaitanya. We are not disagreeing. That is the Moola Siddhanta. But you have to land there. Some people say that, okay, Tattvamasi is what is talked about, then I don't need anything else. I am already that. But then, the person ends up doing anything and everything and claims jnana. That can't work. If one does anything and everything without kartrutva bhava, does not even feel that there is kartrutva, bhoktrutva, then it's a different story. Nobody can know. Siddha prajnyascha ka bhasha ityadi cannot be answered. But that is not the case with the masses. Masses who have just stumbled upon some mahavakya, they can't just assume that everything is all right, I don't have to do anything, and still have a flickery life and get thrown around, want to, improvise, and being a bhokta, very selective bhokta, selective karta, one cannot say that I am mukta. That's not possible. This is similar, You cannot say Chaitanya is Prama and assume that that is all technical. You have to, when you analyze it, then you have to do hair splitting. So when we explain what is the prakriya, you cannot say no prakriya, nothing is needed, everything is Chaitanya, Vishaya Chaitanya, Vishaya Chaitanya, Pramana Chaitanya, everything is Chaitanya. Everything is Chaitanya, then who is talking to whom? So Paramarthika cannot be used in Vyavaharika. There no bhasha is possible. Nothing is possible there. There is no division because there is nothing other than Chaitanya. There we say that Jnanam tu Chaitanyam eva Vedantamate. In Vyavahara, when you are analyzing, Tanna Chaitanyasya Pramatva Padika Vrittirapi. that vritti is also called as prama. So when you talk about jnana, whether it is chaitanya in the lakshana vakya sachidananda brahma or satyam jnanam anantam brahma, there jnanam iti kim chaitanyam chit, there it is right that jnanam tu or prama tu chaitanyam eva. But in the manifested vyavahara, there pramatvapadika vrittirapi prama ityuchyate. Vritti is also called jnana. When what we say jnana, vritti, when jnana takes place, when we say jnana cannot take place if chaitanya, you mean it as chaitanya. Chaitanya does not take place. Chaitanya is there. Not there, chaitanya is the only thing that is there. Not even a thing, really. Vasatiyati vastu, that which really exists is chaitanya, no? Therefore, in the context, vritti is being looked into. Vritti rupa prama is being looked into, not chaitanya rupa prama. So vritti comes and goes. Vritti is not nitya. Vritti is kshanika, really. In fact, vritti is kshanika in all matas. In Vedanta, vritti is not kshanika. Vritti in Vedanta mata is continuous till another vritti replaces it. So as long as another vritti does not come up, it can be anything. Shabda vritti can replace rupa vritti. Rupa vritti is going on, then one vishaya rupa vritti can replace another vishaya rupa vritti. It all may seem simultaneous, but it is sequential. And if there is nothing else going on, one single vritti can be there. Brahmakara vritti. Unless it is displaced by something else, Brahmakara vritti can stay. So vritti, still it is agantuka. Agantuka vritti. It comes and goes. And that is prama. Towards that vritti rupa prama, we need pramana. And then indriya can be pramana, pratyaksha pramana for pratyaksha prama, which is vritti rupa prama. Tasya vritti indriyam karanam. So indriya is a karana. We'll look at each of these, pramatru chaitanya, pramana chaitanya, pramiti chaitanya and prameya chaitanya in the next part. Sukhan mityam saprakasham vyapakam adhishthanam buddhi buddhyam buddher pyatya nirvana param sarvedanta vedyam pratyak paramah tadeva timi nishitamatihi. Any questions? Was the voice clear? I'm on a new machine.
Yes, Guruji, it was very clear.
Okay, so I'm on a new PC and that's why the scroll was faster, no? You can go up and down the PDF. Okay, namaste, I'll see you in the next part.
Hare Krishna.